What's up guys, welcome back to another exciting LumaFusion tutorial. In this tutorial, we're gonna talk a little bit about a new update, which is LumaFusion 2.1. And with 2.1 comes a very special feature that we haven't really seen inside of LumaFusion before, but it's really been requested, I guess, since they added this over some of the other features. But there is a way we can use these blend modes to our advantage when we are making videos inside of LumaFusion. And that's exactly what we're gonna do in this video. I'm gonna show you four super simple ways of using blend modes inside of LumaFusion for your videos and how we can use it with some pretty awesome overlays. And if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe and smash that notification bell. Give this video a big thumbs up. It really helps a lot. And with that said, let's jump over to LumaFusion and dive into the blending modes. So here we have the project that we will be working on for this new blending modes, which is implemented into the new update, which is 2.1. So 2.1 also comes with some layout changes, and one layout change which I really noticed right away was the one we see inside of edit. You can see the touch bar on the bottom here, they have changed that a little bit, and I kind of like the look of how it looks right now. This looks a lot cleaner than the previous one, and I kind of like this one. So good job LumaTouch, this looks pretty awesome. But for this tutorial, we're going to take a look at the brand new overlay modes, and we're just going to jump right into it. And the first thing we want to do is to make these three text layers here, or these are actually video files. This are Wiggle text, which I created as a preset inside of Premiere Pro. And now I can finally use this inside of LumaFusion without doing massive changes and adjustments inside the chroma key effect. Because what we can do to make this look a lot cooler right away is to actually make the text which you see here, all the letters here, we want to show the video inside these different layers. And before, we had to do a lot more work than we actually have to do now, because the only thing we have to do with the new blending modes is to go into edit on one of these text layers or the video files, and we're going to use these as an overlay. So we're going to go into edit by tapping on the pencil on the bottom section here, and then we're going to go to frame and fit if we're not directed to frame and fit right away. And on the bottom right corner here, you see blending. So now we're going to choose blending, and you have different options here. We're going to cover those later, but for this text, as we want the video file to be shown inside of the letters, we're going to choose the blend mode darken. And here you can see that the video file just popped up inside these letters, and we maintain the black background around the text. So what we do now is to simply go to this notepad here and tap on that and copy the effect. We can go back to our timeline, tap on the next two video clips, and paste the effect to these video files, just like that. And if we now scrub through, you will see that the car is coming in the background through the letters. As you can see here now, the car is coming into the background, and at the end we have the text zooming in. Well, it should zoom in, and we can actually fix that. So we can go to this point right here, go to frame and fit, make sure that we're in size and positioning, make a keyframe, go to the end, make another keyframe, and then we can just increase the size with two fingers, just like this. Go out to our timeline, and since we have a cross dissolve added at the end, this zoom in will fade away. So we can now do a playback, and we can take a look at what it looks like. Just like that, super clean. So now moving over to the next one. This first text, this has the darken mode, which allows us to see the video inside the white letters. And moving over to the next one, on this one we want to remove the background and we want the white text to stay. Before, we had to do some changes to this inside the chroma key section as well, But now we can simply go over to edit by double tapping or the pencil on the bottom and go to blend mode, change the blend mode to screen. There you can see we removed the black background and we now have the white text visible inside our video. And moving over to the next one, this is a light ray overlay, and this is really tricky to use inside of LumaFusion. I have applied a chroma key to the next one here, and this is basically the only way we could adjust the overlay before without changing the opacity on the blend mode, and it just wouldn't look great at all. So let's take a look at the same overlay, which is here, but when we applied a chroma key to it. And as you can see here, this does not look good at all. So we really want to add some blend modes to get this even out and to remove the blackness and to get the smoother feel to the light ray overlay. And if we take a look at this overlay right here, what we want to do is to double tap to enter edit mode, go over to frame and fit, and change the blending mode to screen. Once we change the blending mode to screen, we can go out to our timeline and we can scrub through so you can see exactly how this changed the way of using overlays inside of LumaFusion. Just like that. Super clean, super nice overlay, super fast, and it just in two taps and you're done. So this is really a game changer when it comes to using overlays inside LumaFusion. And I bet we can do the blending modes to do some really nice effects and do some really cool video editing or implement that into our videos to make some really cool looks. Moving over to the last clip here, you can see that this clip is way overexposed. And I made this overexposed to illustrate how we can actually change the overexposure and control that, as well as doing some light color grading and color correction using blend modes. So if we take a look at the settings here, you can see that I brighten up the video as well as I change the highlights to maximum to illustrate this overexposed kind of hack. So we're gonna keep this on and we're gonna go over to our timeline and we're simply gonna duplicate this video file. So now we have two video files which is overexposed, and I'm gonna take this video file right here and move it over to the top of the other one. And on this video file, we're simply gonna go into edit. This is the one on track number two. Go into edit and then over to frame and fit and over to blending. You can see the blending and mode and normal, darken, multiply, burn all the way down to hue, saturation, and luma. But what we want to change to here is to multiply. And you can see the color changes in the video right away. So if we go over to our screen here, over to our main project, and we keep it at that spot right here, it's a little bit overexposed in the sky here and in the water with the clouds out, but that is something that you can adjust after you fix this. So this is a really cool way and a nice trick and a nice hack to actually fix your overexposure in just a matter of time without having to go into color and effects and add some color presets to change the exposure. You can simply do this to get a quick fix to your video. So this is the overexposed video. So if we now check this eye here again, so we can see the layer on track number two, which is the one with the blending mode multiply, you will see that we get some nicer colors here, some darker colors, and we kind of lower the exposure overall. So there you go. Here we have four different techniques and hacks that you can use when you are editing your videos using blend modes inside of LumaFusion. So with that said, I really hope you learned something new when it comes to blend modes inside of LumaFusion. This is a brand new feature and we will be diving more into that when we are creating some cinematic videos as well. But I would really like to see LumaTouch step up the game and actually add speed ramping and some better color correction wheels features, and also some more presets like replicate mirror, a proper mirror, which is the replicate one, and also some different features and different presets that we can work around to make more animations. We all know KineMaster for Android already has this, so it shouldn't be a problem at all. So I would really like LumaFusion to focus a little bit more on the filmmaking YouTube content creator way of editing inside LumaFusion instead of just focusing more towards the business creations of this app. So that's my thought of the 2.1 update for now, and I wish they added more, but I guess we have to wait a little bit longer to see some of those features inside LumaFusion. But LumaFusion is one of the best apps out there, and if it wasn't for LumaFusion, I would still be editing all my major stuff on Premiere Pro. But now after the latest updates, which is the 2.0 and 2.1 and all that, it gets more like Premiere Pro-ish, and I kind of like that, so I can actually edit in the couch instead of getting a laptop, Premiere Pro, or sitting here and edit everything on my PC. So really good job so far to LumaTouch. And with that said, I think it's time to wrap up this video. And as always, don't forget to subscribe, smash that notification bell, give this video a big thumbs up if you liked it, share it if you found any value in this video. And until next time, make sure to create some awesome stuff inside of LumaFusion. And I see you guys in the next video.